Okay, here's one version of this function. First, what we do is we take the month string from the user. If it's there, you know, if it's a non-empty string, I capitalize it because the list I include before of all of the months has the days capitalized. And if that capitalized month is in that list, return that value. So let's try a couple versions of this. Valid month January, and we run this. We see it prints January. Let's try July. I run this, and it prints July, and everything's formatted nicely and all is well. Okay, now let's try entering some junk in here. Okay, we run this, and it returns nothing. And what happens if I enter in nothing? We get nothing. Okay, so this seems to be working. Now, what if we wanted to make this a little bit more user-friendly, so the user doesn't have to type in a complete month and spell it correctly? Here's the change I would probably make. So at the top of this file, we have a list of months. You know, what I'm going to do is I'm going to build a dictionary, a mapping of just the first three letters of the month name to the month name itself. So we're only going to match on the first three letters of what the user enters. Okay, so I've added this dictionary. And for m in months, which is our list from above of the month names, we're going to make a mapping of the first three letters of that month. That's what this m colon 3 is, lowercase, using the lower function, to the month name itself. And if I were to print that out, it looks like this down here. MAR to March, Feb to February, August to August. You get the point. Now, this isn't in any particular order because in Python, dictionaries aren't ordered. Now, let's update the main function here to use this new dictionary. Okay, so now I've made the changes. We still say if month, and now I'm making a new variable called short month, which just equals the first three letters of whatever the user typed in, lowercase. So first three letters, lowercase. And then I use the get function on a Python dictionary to see if those first three letters the user typed in is in that mapping. And if it is, we return the value from that mapping, which in this, that's what the get function does. It says, if our key is in the mapping, return the value. Otherwise, return none. And so we're going to return either that value or none. Let's try this out together. So print valid months. Okay, so I run this function on January like we did before, and it prints out January with a capital J. That's the behavior we had before. Let's try something a little bit different. What if I type in just Feb? If I run this, we get February with a capital F. So now our date form, or our date field in our form, will be able to accept a wider variety of things. And if you're like me and you can never spell February correctly, you know, I'll misspell this, and I hit run. We still get February nicely. And so this is nice. So I can type in any sorts of junk, and if the first three letters match a month, you know, we can assume the user was probably on the right track. Okay, see? December.